track myths, legends, and lies. You're not going to believe where we're at today. We've decided to start at where the Santa Fe Trail started from. You know, we've done a lot of the history without the Southwest. We've been through Arizona and New Mexico. But today we're in a historical town, which was the start of basically most of the major trails going westward. Now, Independence, Missouri was the start of the California Trail. It was the start of the Santa Fe Trail. So the families would come up from St. Louis to Kansas City on the Missouri River, on riverboats. They would stop here. They would get all their provisions, their wagons, and everything they needed to head west. They would get themselves set up on a wagon train to make that trip. So they would all start from here. Now, during that time, this was a hotbed of the Civil War. There was a bunch of people. This was a really divided area where people really, where the South and the North really were divided down the middle. And so some of the bloodiest battles of the Civil War, guerrilla style especially, happened within this area, whether that be Bloody Bill Anderson or Quantrell or any of the Jayhawkers and those associations. Now, two groups of those militia were Jesse and Frank James, the notorious bank robbers that are all over history. Now, we've come today to find the final resting place of one of those, right? We know that Jesse was buried in Kearney, Missouri, which is just north of Kansas City. And we know that that he was buried there near the homestead. But Frank's a different story. And so when we were searching Frank's final resting place, you know, he's not up there with his brother, which we found to be kind of unique. You know, we kind of found it to be funny that he would be located in a different cemetery in Independence, Missouri. Now, he's in a place called Hill Park. So what we're doing today is finding Frank James' final resting place. Now, we're in William M. Hill Park. Now, it was donated by Joe Hill, who donated the park to the city of Independence, but the family grave plot was on that land. And it's funny that we have found Frank James. Now, my thought is that why would Frank James be here? Why wouldn't he be up north, right? Well, my thought is that Hill probably was a Confederate sympathizer. And so that's why he was able to decide to have Frank James and his wife laid to rest here at the Hill family plot. And so it's a pretty unique place. And it's in the middle of a park, and it's just a small family cemetery. So we're gonna go in and take a look. This is what it looks like. So there is the final resting place of Frank James. Now, one of the most incredible things about this resting site is, first off, you know, why was he buried here? You know, again, I think it was because maybe Hill was a Confederate sympathizer, and that's why he was laid to rest in the Hill family plot. I don't know that to be a fact, but that's the way this town was. It was so divided on Union and Confederate. And one of the stories is this. So Jesse James was assassinated, right? And he was known to be, the brothers were kind of being known to be modern day Robin Hoods, where they would steal from the rich and give to the poor. Well, it's also believed that those two also were involved in those bank robberies were for getting money to the Confederate side, is why they robbed those banks and those trains, was to give more money to the Confederates. Now, one of the things that's really funny about Frank James was he wasn't laid to rest here until 1944. So if we look at the gravesite, right, what we realize, you know, he died in 1915. And for an outlaw, that was a long life. But he wasn't laid to rest till 1944 because he was so afraid that grave robbers were going to steal his body. The first thing he did was have it cremated. And then the second thing is they didn't lay him to rest until she died. So when his wife died, Anne, then guess what? Then they laid him to rest in 1944. Now his body was kept in a deposit box in a bank until 1944, until that she died. And that it's just an absolute incredible story. And so we have found the grave of Frank James, notorious outlaw. Jay Schreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies on the Road to Independence. Jay Schreck, Myths, Legends, and Lies. I'm in historic Jackson County Jail that was made in 1859 that held various prisoners along with Frank James. And back in 1882, Frank James, the notorious James Brothers, right? In 1882, he surrendered and he was ended up on a rail car from Jeff City because he surrendered to the governor. And then what happened was he showed up and they brought him into cell. But the thing about Frank James was because he was so loved by the people of Independence, especially the pro-slavery, you know, they treated him differently than they did normal prisoners. So it was said that he got preferential treatment than no others, and was able to even leave the jail with people. Now, people would actually bring him gifts. And so when you look at a cell, let's look at an average cell right here. Now let's take a look at Frank James' cell and then tell me if you see a difference. Now he was in this jail for 112 days. And you know, he was acquitted of all charges, which was really incredible, considering that people knew that Frank James, they knew his history. And the fact that they acquitted him also showed you that it was a little bipartisan in Independence at that time, I'd say.